Hello, everyone. Very good afternoon. In the previous class, we discussed about data explorations. We particularly talked about how to generate four different types of graphs like histogram, bar plots, box plots, and scatter plots, right? And now we stopped, if you remember that I have everything that we discussed in the last, and we stopped over here. Yeah, the last thing that we have done is plotted the scatter plot. Okay, the scatter plot tells us the relationship between one numerical variable with respect to the other numerical variable. Okay, and discuss that while interpreting a scatter plot, why we should always say that when one variable is increasing, the other variable is roughly increasing or decreasing, because we do not find a strict increasing or decreasing, a monotonic increasing or decreasing relationship. Okay, whatever is the decrease, increase or decrease that we see, it's kind of like a trend. Okay, and the data is really in a noisy fashion around that trendy line. Now, I will talk about another thing, which is a scatter plot matrix. Now, in the next class, we will be discussing linear regression, and then there I will discuss why we need such a thing.